Hello, bookish friends. Welcome to my July wrap-up part one. In this video, I will talk about the 9 works that I finished and one book that I DNF'd in the first half of July. Like I did with my previous wrap-ups, I will insert the clips very soon after I finish those works. I also have a special guest for this blog. Today is the 2nd of July and I finished two works that I was reading for Janelle-a-thon. The first one was the next book in Hercule Poirot series, which was One to Buckle My Shoe. In this book, written in 1940, Hercule Poirot investigates the death of a dentist that he was a patient of, which seems to be like a suicide at first. But as more and more people get murdered, it is clear that it was not a suicide like Hercule Poirot suspected in the first place. Poirot tries to find out if this was a murder motivated by personal reasons or part of international espionage. I really enjoyed this Hercule Poirot book, and while listening to this book, I thought of Janelle a lot. I mentioned that it was my next book in Hercule Poirot series. She mentioned that it was quite a good mystery, and she was right. Although I suspected the killer, I had no idea about the motivation. I thought the mystery was very, very cleverly constructed. And I'm quite enjoying Hugh Fraser's narration in Agatha Christie books, but especially in Hercule Poirot books, because he played Hastings in my favorite adaptation. But that does not diminish really good narration of him with nuances that makes the listening experience a joy. Agatha Christie's writing was at best, because this was a mystery written in her peak years, 1940s. So I enjoyed this Poirot mystery a lot and gave it 8 out of 10. The second work that I finished for Janelle-a-thon was a novella written by Jane Austen. This was a reread for me. I really do like works written in epistolary format. And that's why, even though I am not a big fan of Jane Austen's juvenile works, I thought this was one of the best. And I gave this unfinished novella by Jane Austen, Laisley Castle, a 7 out of 10. Today is the 5th of July and I finished not one, not two, but 3 works. I think that's the very interesting aspect of reading more than one book at once. The first book that I finished was a short story collection from a Turkish author, which was titled Karşı Kıyının Işıkları by Fatma Gürel. This book consists of short stories featuring characters with very different characteristics. However, I think the most interesting thing about the book, considering the meaning of the title, which means lights from the other side, is that the author tried to write the lives of people who are very different from her. This collection was a mixed bag for me. I didn't understand why some of the stories were even written, whereas I just loved some of the short stories with their messages and also with their very, very interesting characters, and quite a number of them had a good twist of fate, which is the trick of, I think, a good short story. I gave this short story collection, Karşı Kıyının Işıkları by Fatma Gürel, a 7 out of 10. Next work that I finished was a non-fiction essay collection, which I read for Jane Austen July. The title was quite long. The Jane Austen Diet, Austen's Secret to Food, Health and Indescent Happiness by Brown Kozlowski. I actually did a trial chapter video about non-fiction books about Jane Austen, and this book came the second. And as the title suggests, the book tries to find Jane Austen's attitude towards eating, food, health, exercise, also small details of life which brings joy. Because the subject matter always interests me, especially the views towards moderate eating and moderate exercising, which I fully support. Were interesting to hear that Jane Austen also thought the same as I did. However, I have to be honest with you. Although the author quoted from Jane Austen's books and letters, I can say that the book mostly consisted of ways of eating, exercising, and habits in the British Regency period. But that was also another alternative to the Jane Austen July prompt. So this book fitted both of the alternatives in the prompt. The writing was quite clear. Maybe the author shouldn't make jokes because I didn't find them funny. This book quite surprised me actually. And I gave Jane Austen Diet by Brian Kozlowski a 8 out of 10. The last work that I finished was a very, very short audiobook. This was a short story belonging to the Winston Brothers series by Penny Reed, Baird in Waiting. This short story takes place after the events of the third book. And it consists of a couple, very, very interesting actually. I never thought that we would have a story following those anti-heroes of other books. It was quite sexy, but it wasn't over the top. However, it was too short for my taste, and I gave Baird in Waiting by Penny Reed a 6 out of 10. But it was enough to make me want to get into the series again after not reading the fourth book for 2 years. Today is the 10th of July and I finished two works today. The first one was a book that I was listening for my real life book club, which was called Yabancı by Albert Camus. I previously read a play by this author and I really did not like that play. However, when Yabancı became the book for July, I thought I should give it a try. I'm also using this book for the prompt of a second chance author in Summer Book Bingo. In this book, we follow a young man from Algeria when Algeria was a French colony. And one day he receives a call from the elderly house that his mother is living in, saying that his mother passed away. Our narrator is actually kind of sad but not devastated. From this event, we find out that he is unable to feel any emotion, and thus he is a stranger to all of the things that is going all around him. In the next chapters of the book, he befriends a neighbor as well as getting into a relationship with a young woman. And one day a very bad incident happens at a beach, which changes the life of our narrator forever. After really not liking the previous book that I've read by this author, I was really pleasantly surprised by how much this book engaged me. As the author intended, I did not connect with the main character. However, it was very interesting to see everything from his point of view. And the second half of the book, there was a strong message about the very strange legal system which still exists in most of the countries. So I thought it was a very good social commentary as well. The writing style and the translation of the book was very successful. I gave Yabancı, The Stranger by Albert Camus an 8 out of 10. The second work that I finished was an e-arc that I received from Book Sirens, which was Repositioning Lost Love Found by Janine Lauren. In this romance story with elderly characters, after her husband passes away, Maria decides to live her life in cruise ships and traveling and taking lots of photos. She tries to get over her grief with this method. In her latest trip with her best friend, she encounters her first love, who is divorced and is traveling with his younger son. And our couple decides to reconnect and try to find out what really happened between them. This story was not a traditional romance story in details, although it follows the formula of a second chance love. I really liked how the characters were not afraid to communicate with each other. Maybe that could be because they were both over 50 years of age and did not want to contain their feelings any longer. I also found the aspect of living in cruise ships very, very interesting. My parents are also a big fan of cruise travel. There was one plot point which I'm not very fond of in romance stories. And I have to say, even though I liked them, I didn't connect with any of the characters in an emotional level. So I gave Repositioning Lost Love Found by Janine Loren a 7 out of 10. Today is the 12th of July. And I finished the middle grade book that I was reading for Jane Austen July, which was The Nutcracker and the Mouse King by A.T.A. Hoffman. This German middle grade story was written in 1816, just a year before Jane Austen's death. And it was then translated into a ballet called The Nutcracker by Tchaikovsky. Having seen the ballet, I was interested to read the original story. In this short story, two siblings, one boy and a girl called Maria, receive gifts from their godfather. And one of these gifts is a nutcracker toy with a very disfigured and ugly face. Maria takes a liking to him, and one day when Maria is looking at the toys in her chest, a mouse with five heads attacks Maria, and the nutcracker becomes alive with the other toys and defends Maria's life. When I was reading the short story, I said to myself, I know why this is adapted into a ballet. Because the descriptions were so lively and also sounded very, very fun. And it was sort of like a carnival, which I liked very, very much. And I also really liked the moral of the story, in which a girl finds the inner beauty of a very ugly toy. And thus she is rewarded for her good heart. And I found the tempo of the story very on point. It wasn't very fast, and it was quite suitable for middle grade children so that they would not lose their interest. So this middle grade short story was a surprise favorite of this month. And I gave The Nutcracker and the Mouse King by A.T.A. Hoffman an 8 out of 10. Hello, bookish friends. It is the 14th of July, and I finished one book today and decided to DNF another book. The book that I finished was the book that I was reading for Kindred Spirits Book Club, which was Island Magic by Elizabeth Gooch. This historical fiction with a touch of magical realism took place in Channel Islands in the Victorian period. And it follows the lives of a family consisting of a mother, Rachel, father, Andre, and five children, four girls and a boy. Family operates a farm. And they fall through hard times economically. Rachel, the mother, experiences a seeing of a man that will somehow save their farm. One day, when a sailing accident happens and they looked at the survivors of the wreck, Rachel sees that man that she saw in her seeing and decides to take him to the farm and keep him as a lodger in hopes of her seeing coming true. First of all, I was very, very impressed by the writing style of Elizabeth Gooch. Her descriptions of nature were really beautiful. I also really liked the way that she formed her characters very, very distinctively from each other. It's not easy to have five siblings with very distinctive five characteristics, and she managed to do that. My favorite part of the book was the family relationships and how they connected with that stranger, especially with the children. However, because I was very much spoiled by the inaccurate focus on the romance part of the book, I kept dreading a romance. I certainly could have done without the not so focused element of romance in the book. I thought this book would be much better if that plot point had not been done. Also, there were some updated views about women's beauty, which bothered me a bit. That's why I gave Island Magic by Elizabeth Gooch a 7 out of 10. But I will certainly read more books from her, since I really did like her writing style and the way that she formed her characters. The book that I decided to DNF was the book that I was reading for my Real Life Book Club. It was called The Rivers of London by Ben Arowich. It seems like that I really have trouble with urban fantasy subgenre. And I also really did not like when a mystery is put backwards with other details. Additionally, this book kept introducing new paranormal elements to our existing world, which made it even harder for me to follow the plot. I could go on until 50% just because it was a book club book. When I realized that I was just screen reading it, I decided not to waste any of my time on this book, and I DNF'd The Rivers of London by Ben Arowich. So those were the 9 works that I finished, and one book that I DNF'd in the first half of July. So please comment down below, have you read any of the works that I mentioned in this video, and what did you think of them? If you're a new viewer, first of all, welcome. Please like and subscribe. Hope to see you very soon. Bye. Turkish word of the day will be introduced by my young nephew Ateş.
The word of the day is shoe. Shoe means ayakkabı in Turkish, and ayakkabı is our Turkish word of the day. Have a good day.